anything else I need to say. We do have some visitors among us today, and we welcome you. It's usually not my habit to call on you and have you stand up and tell us all about yourselves and like that. I don't want to embarrass anybody, so. And I know when Linda and I go and visit different congregations, we usually try to find a place to hide. So that doesn't happen. And so anyway, we're glad that you're here. As we gather in our gospel for today, the Old Testament commandment was used to try and show the disciples as lawbreakers. And Jesus replied, "The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath." None of us, because of our sinful condition, can keep the letter of the law. The cross of Christ sets us free from the guilt of not keeping the law. Those who accuse others of not keeping the commandments often are legalistic and do not understand the sacrifice Jesus made to set us free from the law. Do not let another person's interpretation of the commandments bring guilt into your heart. Christ died to set us free from that. Live in the freedom and the forgiveness of the cross. We rise to sing. Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
What is man that you are mindful of him?
The Son of Man that you care for him.
Yet you have made him a little lower than the heavenly beings.
And crowned him glory and honor.
You have given him dominion over the works of your hands.
You have put all things under his feet.
Before there was light, God knew each of us by name.
He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him.
God chose us and how we are made to bring honor and glory to himself.
Everything in this world was made by the Maker of God, not us.
Yet we have rebelled against our Creator. Let us confess our sins to God our Father.
We confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone.
For these sins and all sins against you, we confess our guilt and ask for your mercy. Because of what Jesus did for us, we plead for the blood to cover all our sins. Hear the good news. Do more than hear it. Believe it with your heart that God has forgiven all your sins because of Jesus' sacrifice for you. Receive that forgiveness in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, for molding us as we are. Use us as part of your plan to make Christ known to the world and to our neighbors.
For God alone, my soul waits in silence.
From him comes my salvation.
For God alone, my soul waits in silence.
For my hope is from him.
He only is my rock and salvation. My fortress.
I shall not be shaken.
On God rest my salvation and my glory.
My mighty rock, my refuge is God.
Trust in him at all times, O people. Pour out your heart before him.
God is refuge for us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
For God alone my soul waits in silence.
From him comes my salvation.
Eternal God, your Son Jesus Christ is our true Sabbath rest. Help us to keep each day holy by receiving his word of comfort, that we may find our rest in him, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Our Old Testament reading is found in Deuteronomy chapter 5, verses 12 through 15. Observe the Sabbath day to keep it holy as the Lord your God commanded you. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, you or your son, or your daughter, or your male servant, or your female servant, or your ox, or your donkey, or any of your livestock, or the sojourner who is within your gates, that your male servant and your female servant may rest as well as you. You shall remember that you are a slave in the land of Egypt, And the Lord your God brought you out from there with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. Therefore, the Lord your God commanded you to keep the Sabbath day. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our Psalm is 81, 1 through 10. Oh, that my people would listen to me.
That Israel would walk in my ways.
Sing aloud to the God our strength.
Shout for joy to the God of Jacob.
Raise the song, sound the tambourine.
The sweet lyre of the harp.
Blow the trumpet at the new moon.
At the full moon on our feast day.
For it is a statute for Israel.
A just decree of the God of Jacob.
He made it a decree in Joseph.
When he went out over the land of Egypt.
I hear a language I had not known.
I renew your shoulder of the burden.
Your hands were freed from the basket.
In distress you called, and I delivered you.
I answered you in the secret place of thunder.
I tested you in the waters of Meribah.
O my people, while I admonish you.
O Israel, if you would but listen to me.
There shall be no strange God among you.
You shall not bow to a foreign God.
I am the Lord your God,
who brought you up out of the land of Egypt. Open your mouth wide, and I will fill it.
Oh, that my people would listen to me.
That Israel would walk in my ways.
Our epistle reading is found in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 5 through 12. What we proclaim is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ is Lord. With ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, let light shine out of darkness, has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that the surpassing power belongs to God and not to us. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying in the body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our bodies. For we who live are always being given over to death for Jesus' sake, so that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
The Holy Gospel comes to us this day from the book of St. Mark, the second chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One Sabbath, Jesus was going through the grain fields, and as they made their way, his disciples began to pluck heads of grain. And the Pharisees were saying to them, "Look, why are they doing what is not lawful on the Sabbath?" And he said to them, "Have you never read what David did when he was in need and was hungry? He and those who were with him, and how he entered the house of God in the name of Abiathar, the high priest, and ate the bread of the presence, which is not lawful for any but to eat, but the priest to eat, and also gave it to those who were with him. And he said to them, 'The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is Lord even on the Sabbath.'" This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May be seated.
Thank you.
peace be unto each and every one of you this day and always. From God our Father in heaven and from our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The text for our message today is the epistle lesson, read just a few moments ago. Dear Christian friends, how many of you have ever felt the pressures of life? Let's not fool ourselves. We live in a fallen world, and we are surrounded by everyday troubles and stresses. There's financial stress, family pressures, personal struggles, stress at work, and we live in a nation of conflict. Some of us are at that point in our lives where we feel as if we just can't make it anymore. For one reason or another, we may feel like we are at the end of our rope. You may be asking yourself, why am I going through this? And am I the only one who's having this trouble? And how can I bounce back from it? Remember back in the 70s, the Ed Sullivan Show? It was sponsored by Timex Watches, and they had a slogan. It can take a licking and keeps on ticking. It raises the question, how then can we endure the lickings of life and keep on ticking? I almost feel like I should be saying the speech that Rocky gave his son in the movie, remember? And how hard life can be. And it'll knock you down and keep you there if you let it. Well, the Apostle Paul addresses this very issue in our text, 2 Corinthians. First, he tells us, you're going to have problems. And Paul wrote the majority of the New Testament having to deal with problems at the same time. He was shipwrecked 3 times. He was beaten. He was put in prison multiple times. And there were issues in the churches that he started. Issues in the Corinthian church especially. And Paul talks about having to deal with a thorn in the flesh daily. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who you are, how spiritually mature or immature you are. You're going to experience problems and pressures in life. Being a Christian doesn't mean that the world and your enemies are going to cut you any slack. In fact, it'll probably intensify. Paul describes the types of problems and stresses that we all face and how we are free or how we go about facing them. I'm pressed, but not crucified, not crushed, he says. Hard pressed on every side. This is the pressure of the world. But I'm not crushed. Why? Well, look at it this way. If you try to crush a soda can and it's full, it's going to be pretty difficult. Crushing an empty can is easy to do. We could say that the full can is hard to crush because it isn't open to the world. The empty can is easily crushed because it is open to the world and there's nothing in it. We are pressed, but not crushed. That is because we are not open to the world and we allow Christ to be our strength. It's that way with all of our troubles and problems. When Christ is within us, we're strong. We don't freak out. We are not confused. Christ is all-knowing. He's omniscient. He is in control. All things work together for good to those who love God. So we can press forward. Sometimes we get knocked down. Not knocked out. We may be afraid to get up again. Fear can keep us from doing that. Doubt can keep you down. But the only person keeping you on the mat is you. The devil can't keep you down because Christ is in you. Because Christ is in me, the devil and every demon in hell cannot keep me down. And it's the same with you. Most important, come to the realization that it's not about you. It's always all about Christ. Christ needs to be the main thing. And without Christ, we can be crushed. We can freak out. We can be broken. We can be knocked out. In our text, Paul uses the image of a clay jar. In the ancient world, clay jars had a number of uses. These containers made of earth were used to prepare food and to bake food and to store food. They were used to contain drinking water and wine. Interestingly enough, they were also used to store money. Archaeologists over the years have dug up hundreds of these jars in which they found coins. Clay jars were the ancient world's version of the piggy bank. So when Paul said, "We have this treasure in jars of clay," he meant that we have God's Spirit within us. And his audience, they understood what Paul was saying. They got his point. As we place our earthly treasures into a clay pot, God places his divine Spirit within us. You can picture a jar of clay. It may have some chips and imperfections. Paul is saying that we are all basically crackpots. Cheap jars, fragile and porous. It's a good description of you, a good description of me. Some of us are clay jars that are a little rounder than others. Because it acknowledges the truth that none of us has it all together. So today, I'm going to close this message with a prayer. Pray. Lord Jesus, we pray for this world groaning for redemption. We join our voices with all who yearn for wholeness. Our bodies are fragile and shattered. May we find comfort in your grace, made real through kind hearts and helping hands. You formed us with the care and imagination of a potter, but we have lived as imperfect creations, failing to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with you. Still, you never abandon us. You shape and you reshape us, and you breathe new life into us so that our lives might glorify you. Embrace us with your love and surround us with your peace. Fill us, we pray, so that we might pour ourselves out in service to the gospel until all creation flourishes. It's in your name that we pray. Amen. Now, say to the person sitting next to you, because of Christ, you are a beautiful clay jar. In the name of Jesus, Amen. We continue with the hymn.
Pray for our brother Aubrey Victor's
We pray for his continued healing, O Lord. Let him know of your love. Let him feel your love in his heart. Let him know that each day is a gift from you. So be with him now. Give him that strength, courage, hope, faith that he needs for the days ahead. Your word commands us to pray for kings and all in authority, that we might live our lives in peace. We lift up all world leaders, those of our enemies as well as allies. We lift up all in authority in every place, asking you would give each one of your spirit and wisdom on how to govern our world, that we might live in peace. Lord Jesus, you remind us to care for those suffering and oppressed. We remember those who at this moment are in prison because they are bold to preach your name. Give them strength, especially those whose lives may be taken from them today.
We also remember the homeless, those living in poverty and hunger, and those who are not able to find a job.
Be with all, give relief, comfort and hopes according to your will.
Heavenly Father, there are others we know that are not on this list who need your help.
Hear our prayers now as we bring those people before your altar in our hearts.
We bring these and all prayers before your throne, asking according to your will that you hear us.
We pray these things in the name of Jesus, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated. Continues with the celebration of the sacrament as it begins with the preface on the top of page 11. Your worship folder. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and in the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us to do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth, to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers. Deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup when he had supped and had given thanks. And he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
O Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, in giving us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Thank you.
firm in the faith until life everlasting. Depart now in peace, serving the Lord daily. And in his name, amen.
Thank you.
God, that you have refreshed us through this salutary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same, in faith toward you, and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Amen.
Go in peace.